I've been looking for a wireless video transmitter system for quite some time now, and when the folks over at Hollyland Tech reached out to me and said that they would send me one of their units, I jumped on the chance to get my hands on one. This is the Marus 400S, and it packs a lot of features into a small package. And in this video, I'm going to tell you everything there is to know about the 400S. The 400S is a stable and reliable wireless video transmitter unit for video productions of all different scales. I mean, key features include up to 400 feet line of sight distance and both HDMI and SDI inputs and outputs. It effortlessly transmits up to 1080 60p through HDMI or 1080 24 through SDI. I'm really excited to roll this into my production setups because I can't tell you how many times I've wanted to be able to separate myself from the camera and still see what's going on. Everything from product shots and commercials to working with clients and allowing them to see what's going on without, you know, having them looking over your shoulder. These are the perfect situations for having a wireless video setup. The first thing you notice when you pick up this unit is the build quality. It's solid and it's got that high quality feel from the smooth metal finish. It is, however, lightweight without feeling fragile, which is awesome. And of course, I strap a big battery onto it. It ends up weighing more, but you know, you could get a smaller battery and it would be a lightweight addition to any rig. With electronics like this, it can be hard to tell what kind of experience you're gonna have with it based on the programming of the unit itself. And it was a pleasure to discover that right out of the box, the Marus 400S, it just works. Like,
I literally didn't have to do anything with it. I just installed a battery on both the transmitter and the receiver side. I booted it up and it just worked.
It's comforting to know that during the high pressure environment of film shoots that this'll just work without having to mess with it. The last thing I want to do is spend time trying to figure out, you know, what's going on with my rig and why I can't get a signal.
The top feature in my book when it comes to the Marus 400S is the HDMI and SDI inputs and outputs.
And what that means is flexibility. This is a unit that you can take with you to all kinds of shoots with different cameras and different setups and different client needs. And more importantly, along with flexibility is growth. I mean, I'm looking forward to having this setup for a really long time. Even after I buy a new camera that has, you know, different outputs or like new monitors that have different inputs. The 400S also has three separate switching modes, which is really useful for different environments. The image mode allows you to get the highest quality image from the transmission regardless of the latency or distance. The speed mode allows you to get the lowest latency possible based on your conditions. And then lastly, the balance mode will give you the most of both modes depending on your surroundings and how the signal is reacting, you know, to your set.
So you would choose one of these modes based on environmental conditions.
Choosing between the modes is simple. You just enter the menu and select a scene mode and then select the mode that you want.
There's also a built-in channel scan function, which is really nifty. What that does is it'll scan the channels available in the area and it'll tell you which ones are good to use and which ones are bad and might have interference. And lastly, this one is pretty handy. It's a low battery indicator, which will tell you when you're starting to run low on power and when you should switch out the battery. It's about 30 minutes before it dies. A little note about latency here. The GH5, which is what I'm using this setup with,
it's got terrible latency whenever like a monitor is plugged into it or whenever an HDMI signal is being sent out. So, and that's the camera's fault specifically. It's unfortunate, but it's just part of the deal with some of these DSLRs.
The latency of the GH5 with a monitor plugged in is about 4 frames or 166 milliseconds. So because of this, it's difficult for me to make a comment about the latency of the 400S without trying it out with a different method. So to really test it, I decided to connect it directly to my computer's HDMI signal out and then record two screens of running timecode in Logic Pro to estimate the difference. Firstly, to do somewhat of a control run, I hooked up the HDMI of my second monitor directly to my Ninja 5 and then mirrored the desktop on both screens. And you can see clearly here that both screens read the same exact time code, you know, give or take slight aberrations in the way that the camera captures it. The second test setup I conducted was with the Marus 400S transmitting as a direct intermediate from the computer's graphics card to the Ninja 5. And you can see the difference here between the two streams. The difference of which looks to me about 2 frames or 83 milliseconds. and I'd say this was perfectly acceptable. It's literally twice as fast as the GH5's direct connection time, and that's okay with me. Another fantastic feature is the ability of the 400S to send out a Wi-Fi video signal for viewing on personal mobile devices. You can connect up to four electronics like smartphones or iPads simply by downloading an app and connecting to the output signal coming from the transmitter. And this is especially useful for things like other crew members, right? Set design or hair and makeup or a script supervisor keeping track of continuity. All these different departments can see what's happening in front of the camera, you know, without breathing down your neck just to see what's on the camera monitor or crowding the camera. I decided to do some field testing with the 400S and see just how far away from my scene I could get. I started out by setting up my camera and the transmitter at the end of an alleyway, and then using a little handheld setup I threw together, I began walking away from it. I was pretty impressed with the distance I could get out of it. I ended up going pretty far, like Google Maps is telling me something like 350 feet. I actually stopped walking when I was over a block away because the truth is that if you need to be further than 400 feet away line of sight from your shoot or your camera setup, then you know you should be using a different transmitter. Like there are other versions, even the Hollyland makes, that are more geared towards something like being used with drones or cranes or you know off-site video villages. But personally, I want to be right there where the action is with the camera and with the actors so I can do things like give performance notes and stuff right away. The good news is that the 400S still works really great when I'm close by but behind a wall or not line of sight. And personally, that's what's more important to me, to be able to hide or to be out of the shot but still see what's going on. All in all, the Mars 400S is an excellent value in a small package. The only thing that you want to be careful of here is that there is a fan inside of these units, so it does make noise. However, it isn't any louder than like my Atomos Ninja 5, which has not been an issue. I'd like it if it was a little bit quieter, but I don't see it being a problem. That's it for my review of the Hollyland Mars 400S. If you're looking for a wireless video transmission system, check out the Mars 400S. It's a pretty awesome little unit. Be sure to subscribe here on YouTube and follow me on Instagram for more cool filmmaking stuff. And until next time, thanks for watching.